Well, it's time to belly up to the bar and find out what's on tap at Brews with Brian. Hey everybody, thanks for joining us again here at Brews with Brian, your weekly craft beer review podcast. Each week I talk about a craft beer from around the world, man. What's got my interest? This week we're going to check out a really, really interesting beer. Let me pull it in real quick. There you go, Tiny Bomb. Tiny Bomb is a beer from a Wiseacre Brewery out of Memphis, Tennessee. The beer is made with German and American Pilsner malt, and it's spiked with 50 pounds of wildflower honey. So you can see why this thing got my interest. Upon opening the can, the carbonation sprung out of it and is down the side of the can. Larger head than expected, a massive white head, really, and it just lingers around, which you love to see. It becomes very sticky and lacy as it fades away. Again, pour this thing in the glass, man. You know, do it right. You'll enjoy it better. Just trust me on that. You get huge aromas of lemongrass and honey. You can see here a picture of the beer poured in the glass. It's actually a tall glass. What better way to drink a beer, you know? But you get huge aromas of lemongrass and honey. Definitely a roasted malt aroma as well. You know, not much more in the aroma. But tasting this beer, it follows the nose really strong. You get the lemongrass, honey, sweet malt aromas. You really get more citrus than grass, which is surprising for a Pilsner. It's really similar to a Helles. It's got tons of honey flavor, yet it finishes surprisingly dry. And this beer just really showcases that 50 pounds of wildflower honey. The mouthfeel has a strong carbonation, but also a heavy body. You know, usually Pilsners are going to be very light. And this body is actually pretty heavy for a Pilsner. It doesn't have enough carbonation to finish off the sweetness, so the sweetness really comes through with this beer. The alcohol is hidden very well. It's only 4.5%, so it's not going to be anything real heavy to drink. You can drink multiple of these and be just fine. But overall, guys, this really is a tiny bomb and not what I was expecting. So much flavor and body here to really hit you in the mouth, which is good because you're drinking it, so you want that experience. It leans slightly more citrusy than other Czech Pilsners, or American Pilsners for that matter. A lot more honey sweetness, yet it has a Munich malt profile. It doesn't really fit any beer style, and it's unique on its own. And it's a blend between a Helles and an American Blonde, in my opinion. This is no ordinary Pilsner, and it's definitely a gem just for the flavor. So guys, you gotta try this. You have to find it. It's readily available usually at any of your favorite craft beer shops, especially here where I am in North Alabama. But this beer to me pairs well with like baseball and summertime sports because it's so light and just refreshing. And a really big surprise. Like I said, when they named it Tiny Bomb, you know, that they weren't lying. But, guys, let's check in with Bill. You know, we check in with Bill every week. Bill's one of our good friends here at the Loaded Sport Network. You know, like I said, we check in with him every week. Just an amazing person. You know, if you ever get the chance to meet Bill, I highly encourage it. He's going to tell you some stories. It's hard to believe, but every bit of it's true. Got Bill here pouring the beer into the Brews with Brian mug, as he does every week. And let's see what Bill thinks. He's happy, guys. As you can see, usually if I like it, Bill likes it. And here he is, man. He loves it. So we'll check in with Bill next week. Bill, we appreciate it. Thank you, buddy. And now we got what's been a surprising hit with the fans here at Brews with Brian, the Brews with Brian Bar Trivia. The answer from last week was Alka-Seltzer. The question was, what slogan was Flop Flop Fizz Fizz for this product? The answer is Alka-Seltzer. Sort of threw you a curveball. This one had nothing to do with beer or sports. So maybe you got that one right. Wasn't that hard. But the question for this week, how many baseball players take the field in a baseball game? Both teams included. Do you know it? You may know it. You might have to think about it a little bit. But you can check back with us next week, and we'll give you the answer for that one. But that's going to do it for this week's episode of Brews with Brian here on the Loaded Sports Network. And we appreciate everybody for listening. Tell your buddies if they enjoy drinking craft beer, they will enjoy me talking about it. Check out our other shows on the Loaded Sports Network, Spring Loaded Football, you know, the flagship show of this network. Very successful. Check them out. I'm part of it with Wayne and Coach. And, guys, that's going to do it for us here at Brews with Brian. And don't forget, stop back by where knowledge is always on tap.